Coming in at number 7, back-to-back billion-dollar tropical disasters, Elsa and Fred. First up, just hours after being classified as a tropical depression, Elsa strengthened and was named a tropical storm on July 1st. Elsa set the record as the earliest fifth named storm in an Atlantic hurricane season, the earliest ever hurricane in the Caribbean Sea. And the next day, after rapid intensification, the storm was upgraded to a Category 1 hurricane, peaking with 85 mile per hour winds and breaking another record, that of strongest July hurricane in the Eastern Caribbean since Emily in 2005. On July 3rd, Elsa weakened into a tropical storm, then slowed down on the 4th of July, passing just north of Jamaica. On the 5th, Elsa made landfall in Cuba, then re-emerged into the Gulf of Mexico on the 6th. It ran parallel to the west coast of Florida and strengthened to a minimal hurricane once again as it passed west of Tampa on the 7th. And before making landfall later that day, Elsa weakened again, striking with 65 mile per hour winds in Taylor County, Florida. After leaving Florida, Elsa continued a damaging path through Georgia, then South Carolina. As Elsa dumped rain on the northeast, water rushed into several New York City subway stations, and flooding continued along the storm's path all the way to Maine. By the time the storm left, Elsa had brought widespread impacts to the entire eastern United States, including spawning 18 tornadoes all the way from Florida to New Jersey, from the Caribbean to Florida, then to the northeast and all the way to Iceland. Elsa was blamed for 4 deaths and around $1.2 billion in damage, $775 million of which was in the U.S. alone. And then, closely following behind Elsa, we got perfect proof why we should never say it's just a tropical storm. Fred was the sixth named storm of the season and was another deadly troublemaker. On August 11th, after previously showing little development, Fred was confirmed to be a tropical storm by a Hurricane Hunter reconnaissance flight into the disturbance, 45 miles south of Ponce, Puerto Rico. A short time later, Fred made landfall just west of Santo Domingo in the Dominican Republic, with a first example of why it's bad to underestimate the destructive capabilities of any tropical system. Because after causing the Dominican Republic's aqueduct system to fail, 500,000 people lost access to fresh water. After weakening to a depression over Hispaniola, Fred continued to move across the Gulf and reached its peak intensity of 65 miles per hour on the 16th, right before making landfall near Mexico Beach, Florida. It dropped copious amounts of deadly rain and spawned tornadoes across the southeast. The worst of the flooding from Fred sparked multiple flash flood emergencies in western North Carolina, resulting in record-breaking flooding, the worst ever recorded in parts of the state. The flooding destroyed roads, bridges, and hundreds of houses and other structures, and the remnants of Fred also brought heavy rains and tornado damage to the northeast too. Causing at least 7 deaths and more than $1 billion in damage, Fred was not just a tropical storm. Because of their cost in lives and property damage, the dual hits from Hurricane Elsa and Tropical Storm Fred come in at number 7 in our top 10 weather events of 2021. To see more of our top 10, go to weathernationtv.com. For Weather Nation, I'm John Van Pelt.